Hey everyone, and welcome to today's video. So we've got a GP3 grill. So I managed to pick this up on eBay, got a really good price for it. So I've not seen many cars, so many F56s with these retrofitted. So I thought, you know what, I'll pick one up and give it a go and try and change the front end of my F56 a little bit. So it's gonna be a bit of a learning curve as we go along. So there's no sort of other instructions or videos on how to fit this. So I'm not 100% sure whether it's gonna directly clip on or whether we're gonna have to do a bit of tweaking here and there to get it to fit the JCW. So it uses a similar bumper on the GP3, but there are some slight differences with some of the grills and bracketry. So we're gonna give it a go, strip that front bumper off so that we can get the stock grill out. Easier to take it off so you avoid breaking any clips or anything on the back. So what I'll do a bit of a time lapse in terms of me removing the bumper, because I've got another in detail video that shows you exactly how to remove the bumper on the front of the F56, so I'm not going to repeat myself. And then we'll go through removing the grill from the bumper, and then finally putting it all back onto the car with the new grill attached. So let's go now, and I'll jump into the video of removing the front bumper. Okay, so if you take a look at the front grill, you can see we're replacing this black plastic bit here and the top grill. So all of this has got to come off, and to remove this, I think you probably could do it with the bumper on, but it'd be an absolute nightmare and you'd risk breaking all the clips behind here on your grill, so you wouldn't be able to retrofit them back on if you ever wanted to swap them over or sell them on. So I'm going to show you a process of removing this bumper and then attempting to fit this. So I can see some differences already at the top, so it'll be interesting to see how this fits, but we'll give it a go and see where we get to. It was to just get to these side bolts. These clips on the trim, you have to be so careful because you don't want to damage the black trim, because if you put too much stress on it, it gets a stress mark and you can never cover that up. So that's that one bolt out. So all that effort was to get one bolt out the top, which releases that top corner. We've got to do exactly the same on the other side. And all we are is just removing this front arch so we can get to this clip that's back here. So there is a little 8mm bolt. That's what I'm using this little socket for, is to remove that. That's like a little pinch bolt. That's in the wheel arch liner. We're just removing that first. That gives us the ability to flex the inner wheel arch liner out of the way, so we can then start working on the little clips behind here. And all we're doing is we're making sure, you could just pull like that, but I worry about damaging these and putting like flex marks in them. So I always try and be a bit more careful, come into the wheel arch and just do as much work as I can in here. Again, there's a video on my channel how to do this, so I'm not going to bring the camera in and show too much detail, but let's go. I suppose the only way to describe that is putting your fingers behind, spreading the load so you're not just pushing in one place, and pull that out and you just get enough grip on it. It's a bit of a tricky one. It's one of those where you're working on the car, you've just got to work it out. You can't really explain it in words. Okay, so that's that second bolt now. Okay, so under the car there's three bolts, one there, one there, and one there. So we're just going to get underneath and remove those. Let's bring you in for this bit. So we've got a number of bolts across the top here. T30 they are. Let's just get those all out of the way. Okay. You can see that bumper. It's coming away from the car, it's nearly there. Okay, so under here we've got a couple of clips because we've got the JCW Pro trim on. I think they come with that. A better tool than that. Okay, so that's a bit of a better tool, hopefully. Corner off. One, two. So I'm hoping now that should be all the clips. All things, we can now lift that away because it's a JCW, there's no lights or anything to worry about. They're all deleted, so there's no cables or anything. So that's a bumper off the car. We're going to put this on the bench and take a look at how we switch the grills over. Okay, so now the bumper's off the car and we've got all of it apart, let's just quickly talk you through a different part. So first of all, we've got the grill surround. You can see the clips all the way around here, all the way around, and that just presses in. So from behind you just pop those out. Car, we need to remove the grill surround, which is these clips. So that's the painted black bit that I've got on my car. Some cars it'll be chrome. So it's a surround that goes all the way around up the top of the grill. So we're looking to remove that first. And for those that say you can remove it while it's on the car, you can see how tricky it is doing it while it's off the car. So imagine trying to do this while it's on the car. What you want to try and do is get your fingers behind it, and as you undo another clip, pull it down so you reduce the risk of it snapping back into place. Okay, then you've got the main grill itself. Now on the front bumper, again, it's just this row of clips that hold it onto the actual bumper. So if I show you there again, they're just those pushing ones that slot into there. So removing that from the bumper is super easy. I'll try and put a clip in here of me removing all the clips off the back of here to get all these parts out. But it's pretty easy to do, pretty self-explanatory once you've got the bumper off. But I'll try and cover it anyway as a bit of help. It's why we're halfway off with that grill. To actually get the whole grill off, that's these clips here. And that may or may not help us. You can see we're just going along and popping these out, which is bringing the whole of that top half of the grill out, which may make it easier to work on removing this black plastic trim. And this should be the last one. You can see now that's the top half of the grill out. Now, if I flip it over, we should see really close. It looks like there must be some clips under here that we've missed slightly. Let's have a look. Ah, I've missed two. One here and one here. That's what's stopping us. Hadn't noticed that before. Get that out. It's one out. And here's the little tricky one here. Missed that completely. So. off. Next, you've got the bumper bar, which goes just on there. Again, you can see, these are these little, and let's bring it close to the camera, little pressing clips. So all you do on the back of there, when it's attached, press those down, pull that out, and you pop those all the way around. That bit comes out as well. So you don't need that, because there's like a honeycomb replacement for that on the GP3 one. So this should be a lot easier now because we can access the clips on the back and see them a lot better. So it runs all the way along here. What I'd recommend is putting your hand underneath, removing the tow and oil latch, and actually positioning fingers so you're pulling this away from the bumper as you undo these clips, so that when you do pop them out, they stay out. Nearly there. That's that off. Okay, so as well as the black grill surround, I think we're actually going to potentially need this top section here off the stock grill. So it actually is just clipped in all the way along. It looks like someone's tried to plastic repair this at some point. Maybe my car was in an accident because it's Cat S, so whether this was damaged in the original crash, and someone sort of throwing it back together. So we can see here, we just need a flat blade screwdriver just to pop all these clips off and get this piece separate to this piece. So I'll go grab them now. Okay, so just taking a look, looks like there's some clips all the way along. Yeah, so that one's already damaged and broken off. It's a little clip right here at the end. Pull that out. Then all we need to do, by the looks of it, maybe coming from the top with a smaller screwdriver, yeah, lift this bit up and out it pops. We've got to do that. So you do it like that, then pull it out. So hopefully we just pop along all the way along, popping those clips out. One, and pull it away constantly. Two, this clip looks like it's already broken from previous repairs, and that one's missing. Lift that up, pop that out, and we go all the way along. Yeah, it definitely looks like someone's had a go at this before. And that's the last clip out. So that's that section. I think we're gonna need that for the GP grill. The other part I want is actually the JCW badge. So I'm actually going to refit this to the new grill. Let's pop these off. So I think on the new grill it actually sticks in place, so I may end up trimming these little nodules off the back, so I'm not being too careful. I don't think we need them on the new grill. I'm not too fussed and breaking them because I think we're gonna have to glue the badge on anyway. Again, take your own preference on how you remove these. I sort of know it's gonna be stuck on, so I'm not too bothered. Someone else might want to be a bit gentler. And that's the JCW badge off. You can see we don't need that. We're gonna stick that in the top of the garage and store that for if we ever need it in the future. Then you've got the front bumper itself. So what we'll do, let's go and grab the GP3 grill and try that against it. You've got these clips that will clip in down here, and that replaces that gloss black section that we had covering here where you'd normally screw your number plate to. Then we've got this row of clips all along here that will clip in across the top of the bumper. Then these are the bits that I'm trying to work out from Mini whether there's an additional bracket, because I don't think this is going to line up properly on the stock, on the car itself. Okay, so we've got all the grills and surrounds off. I'm interested now in just slotting it on and just seeing where it fits and where it doesn't compared to the stock grill. So if we slap this on, okay, so the grills are pretty much lined up in terms of where it is. And for me, the issue is going to be on this piece of trim here, this black plastic. If you look here, there's a clip that just doesn't exist on the stock JCW bumper. There's one close, but not the same. So I'm wondering whether you get a replacement trim for this on the GP, whether we need to cut a slot in it or just remove this clip, because there's so many clips all the way around, it may not be needed. So let me try and work it out and I'll come back.
We'll give it a go. So the easiest thing for us to do, so now we've got all the grills off, is to refit the bumper. So we're going to whack that back on the car, and then this should clip in from the front. So we only removed the bumper so that made it easier for getting all these other bits off the car in the first place. So let's give that a go. Okay, so the key thing to remember with this job is underneath, you've got, for me, I fit the bumper underneath and lift it over just because I've got the pro corners on the front of the bumper, and you need to make sure they're hooked underneath the brackets that are under there, and you need to make sure you don't catch these either and make sure these are on the outside of the bumper so that they're not caught. The other tip is you've got to make sure the top lip of this bumper, so this black bit here, sits on this black bit, and that's pretty much it. So let's give it a go. So I hook it on from underneath and lift up, making sure your arch liners come out on the outside. One thing actually that's never been right on my car is the temperature sensor. That's just on the back of the bumper by the grill. You can just clip that in. For some reason that's never been attached, so I've reattached that now. So next, you get your T30, and there's just a bolt that we removed. One of those. Let's get him in there. He goes through here into this metal bracket. That's that one. We'll go the other end. And we're going to do exactly the same on this end. I should have a bolt in my pocket. Yep. Okay, and the last thing I'm going to do is pop the arches in at the very end, because they're the worst parts to get off. So if you've done something wrong and you've got to remove the bumper again, at least you've not got to fiddle, because these are the fiddliest bits to get off. So leave those hanging until you've got everything back together and do those as the last thing. So they are literally the worst bit to get off of the whole front bumper assembly. Okay, so next we've got these little 8mm bolts or screws, however you want to describe them. One in the middle and one either end, so I'm going to get underneath now. Just attach them, there's three holes, it's really obvious where they come out. Go back in. Okay, so that's the three bolts underneath. So we've got a few clips either end, but we'll do that after we've fitted the grill so that we can make sure this is all in place and ready to go. Let's go grab the grill. Okay, so the next bit, looks like we've got to use this to fill some of the gap. Now I'm interested to know, and I'm going to do a little bit of research, whether the GP comes with a slightly different one of these. Let's get this fitted so it fills this gap. One. Okay, so the next part I wanted to show you was just these grills down here. There's a little grill in the JCW bumper that I don't think is in the GP3 grill or the GP3 bumper. So when you try and, let's just try and show you, fit this, there is a clip. So basically, this clip on the back corner of the GP grill hits that. Now you've got a couple of different options. You can investigate what the GP3 has here, if it's a separate little grill or piece or something. You can remove this or try and trim a little slot in it for the clip on the back. Me looking, there's a lot of clips holding this grill in, sort of along this sort of section up here. I'm thinking actually I'll just trim the clip off the back of the grill. So if we look at the grill, just take it over to the table. So if we look at the back of the grill, I'm talking about these clips here in both bottom corners. And if you look, there's one, two, three. This was broken on mine when I received it, which is why I got it cheap. But then you've got all these clips all along here that attach it to the car. So I think if you lose these bottom corners, I don't think it's gonna be a major thing. Now this step is entirely up to you. So there's lots of options. You can use these and try and cut a slit in that grill that I just showed you on the car. Or you can see what the GP3 is. For my solution, I think these are gonna be enough to hold it in place. So I'll leave this step entirely up to you in terms of how you wanna do it. Because we're retrofitting, it's not always a straightforward clip-on job. So I want you to be aware that there's a decision that needs to be made with your grill here. Okay, so as explained, I'm going to nip these clips off in the corners. So I'm going to use some snips. Nip them off to start with, just to get rid of them. One. Two. And then I'm just going to neaten these edges up. You're never going to see them anyway, but just so they don't hit that grill that's on the car. So just snip, use your snip, so you could use a Dremel to do this or cut it, some sort of cutting tool. Okay, so that's pretty much flat. We'll switch the grill round and we're gonna do exactly the same. Take this one off. Now I know some people have been nervous about cutting up a sort of £300-£400 grill. So you could try the other method of just removing those grills on the car. For me, I want to keep them in place just because they hide stuff behind the bumper that you might not want to see. But if you're not too bothered about that, then feel free to just nip those little grills off the front bumper. So that's those two clips removed. So we're going to now try and see if we can bolt it to the car. Okay, so let's give it a go. So we've got these clips down here. It go into the bottom edge, and it sits really nice. It's really pretty obvious where it goes when you put it against the car. From underneath, you can see where it clips. So for me, just one last check over, because it's the first time I've ever put it against the car. It looks like it's going in place. The bolt holes are going to line up this end and this end for those screws we removed. And this is where I'm talking about up here. This is where whether it's a self-tapper and a big washer, or if you want to see whether the GP3 actually comes with some brackets. That's what we'll work out after, but let's get it clipped on. It looks like it's just going to go straight in place. So I'm just going to check all the clips are lined up. You just go along that top edge of the bumper, push it in, all along, push all the way down, and now you can see that's clipped onto the car, so that's really good, that's gone on really simple. So that's the good bit, that's the bit that we know 100% definitely fits. We bring you in a bit closer, and you can see here, this is where we've got some differences. So it's entirely up to you how you want to make this work. You could leave this out and it might wobble about, which isn't good. There might be some brackets from the GP3 that we might need to purchase, so that's something I'll look into. I'm not going to do anything permanent up the top of here. I'm going to put the grille surround back on so we can see how it looks and close the bonnet. Then what I might do is just a bit of a follow-up video once I've done some research with Mini, because you could either cable tie it if you're not too fussed about the look, or I'm going to see what the GP3 solution is, because I think they use this piece or a slightly different version of this that extends forward and fills this gap here. So, but we can see we've got the grill on, bonnet closed, it will look exactly the same as the GP. Bonnet open, obviously you'll see this. So we'll work out a solution for that and I'll give you guys an update. But let's take the camera back, we'll get the grille surround on, get the bonnet closed so we can see the finished article. Okay, so the grille surround we've got here is the gloss black one that was fitted to the original JCW bumper. So there's no difference, I'm fingers crossed. I've been told it will clip straight back on to the GP surround, so let's give it a go. Let's just be really careful where we're lining up those clips. But it looks positive so far. Yep, that's going back in. Let's go the other side. Just make sure everything's lined up, which it seems to be. And that's clipping on perfectly so far. Yep, so I can confirm you can use the black surround or the chrome surround off your JCW grill, so that's brilliant. Or it's the same actually surround as the Cooper S as well. So that's gone on. This grill is solid across the bottom and the sides in the middle. It's just this top section. Okay, so before we close the bonnet and see the final look, we've also got to address the bolts up here as well. You've got your arch liners. So there was a bolt to go back through here on the back side, some clips underneath, so remember to put those back in. And also then, we know this is in the right place now, so we can push all of these back in, hopefully. It should go on pretty easily. Okay, so don't forget we've got this side as well to go back on. So line up the clips down the bottom, and push everything back in. One. Okay, so I'll leave those loose for a second just on mine, because there's a couple of clips I need to do on the back. That's all pretty much back in place, so I just wanted to remind you guys to do that as well. Then we've got the bolts at the top here. We haven't done those yet, so we can't forget these little bolts. They just need to go in just on these top corners. Right, so that's that one in. Let's go to the other end. Okay, you can see this here is what we're doing. Let's push that all the way back, line that hole up, get it in, get it finger tight. That's that now, all in place. And you can see here, this is where the GP3, to be honest, it's pretty solid. Other than this being bolted down, which I need to sort out, that's an issue with my car. The grill's pretty much solid. I think it does need something along here to secure it, but we can work that out afterwards. Okay, so this clip's filmed a little bit later than the rest of the video just because I lost the weather. But I did want to show you the fact I'm not going to stick with it having a GP badge. That's just not me. So I'm going to remove these badges. Now, from what I know, they're just stuck in place like other decals around the car. So what I'm going to do is introduce a little bit of heat, not too much. I'd rather heat it a bit over time, so I'm not going to put my heat gun on full. Keep it moving and try and get these off without damaging them. There's a video on how to do this on my channel as well, in detail, but what I'm basically going to do is apply heat gently so we don't damage the plastic, but we get enough heat to soften that glue behind here, and they should just peel off, hopefully. Now, it's a bit of a cold day. When I've done these videos in the past, it's been in the summer, and they can really peel off really easily. What you don't want to do with this, because it's textured plastic, it's not paint you can polish up, you really don't want to be jamming stuff behind it to try and get it off. Plus, I don't know whether there's any little locating pegs or whether these are just stuck on. So let's just apply that heat gently, trying to pull away every so often on the under edges so you can get your fingers underneath these GP badges. Let's try and get that off. Now, some people might want to keep these on. That's absolutely fine. That's personal preference. For me, I'm not a fan of having a car badged up in something it's not. Yep, there you go. You can see already, straight off. So you can see there's just glue on the back of those. Now I'm going to put those safely, because I would imagine there's people out there that would pay good money. Keep them in good condition, and I bet you could sell those on. You can see there, we're left with a nice clear place. So it's, you lose your honeycomb. It is in a GP shape. I think once you've got that JCW badge, potentially on that section or in the middle, we'll give it a go. I'll go and get it, the one we removed from the front grill, and we'll try it on there to see. And we're also gonna get a bit of glue remover just to clean up this before we stick anything to it. Okay, so I'm just gonna clean this off with a little bit of tar remover and glue remover, just so any residue that's left on, and we'll leave that to dry. Next up, we've got the JCW badge that we removed from the front of the car. Now you can see it's got pegs on here, so it's up to you. You can reuse the one off your grill, and what we'll have to do is just lop these off, or you can buy a brand new one. There's plenty on eBay that are sort of stick-on ones that would work. So I'm going to try nipping these lugs off and sticking it on and see what it looks like. So I used my little snips from earlier and just drop those lugs off the back of it. They're not needed anymore. They're just so in the factory they can get them central really quickly on the grills. Just take all those lugs off. Again, you could do this with a Dremel or something if you wanted to. This is just the tool I've got to hand. What you want to do, get it as smooth as you can on the back. So I think that's not going quite smooth enough with these clips. I don't think I can get quite in there. So I'm just going to get a little Dremel and take those off the back. But what I'm thinking is, if you stuck that literally there in the middle, you're not going to notice the fact that everything else is GP shaped. So no, I quite like that actually there, smart. So I'm going to go and tidy the back of this up with a Dremel tool just to get rid of these lugs. And then we'll use some double-sided foam tape maybe just to reattach that there, and I think that sits really well. Okay, so I've took the JCW badge, giving it a bit of a clean. Just cleaned all this off as well, just make sure there's no grease or contaminants on there, so that seems all pretty clean now. I've double-sided some tape on the back. Well, it's not actually double-sided, well, it's double-sided tape, it's double-sided foam back tape. And then you've just got to work out where you want to stick your badge. I'm going to try and center it in the center of the block, so this end might be hanging off a bit. And place it where you think you're happy with it. There you go. And we're now not labelling our car up as a GP when it's not. Got a nice JCW badge on, firmly held in place, not going anywhere. Not sure whether I like it. I've centred it on this bit, but actually this is a little bit of overhang. I'll see how I like it. If I'm not happy, it's easy enough to remove it, just like we've removed the GP badge, remove the glue off the back of it and move it along. But at least we're not labelling it up as something we're not. Okay, so we're fighting against the rain here, but everything's back in place. All my clips and everything under the bumper, so I reminded you to do those. Make sure you get them done. Bolts across the top, arches are in place. So let's shut that bonnet and see what it looks like. Okay, so we can see the bonnet shuts. We've got good gappage all the way around, and we can get the final look now of the new grille. Okay, so I'm really pleased with this new look. I think it looks more aggressive. While I had that all apart, I did add these red highlights down here, had this lower section painted black. Fighting against the weather here, it doesn't want me to finish this video, but we're gonna carry on. So I think the grille looks amazing. I'm gonna actually use some heat and take this GP badge off and replace it with the JCW badge. So I'm not a fan of having that GP badge on there when it's not a GP, but that's something I'll do. And I've got a video on how to remove stickers and badges like that anyway. So on the next video, I'll try and do a follow-up to see, work out those brackets across the top and give you guys a bit of an update in terms of what solution I did. But for now, this grill is not going anywhere. That's flexing the grill because it's held in place solid. So I'm not too concerned about that, to be honest. It's not going anywhere, so I'm really not fussed. And I think it's a great addition to the car. Apart from those two clips that we removed at the bottom, there's nothing else we've really had to modify to get it to fit either. So I wouldn't say it's 100% just replace the existing one, because we've had to do that bit of modification or make a choice around there, plus you've got the brackets across the top, but we're 99% there in terms of fit, so I couldn't be happier with it. So if you found the video useful, please like the video, that really helps the channel. Subscribe so you get updates on future videos. We've obviously got a few project cars on the channel now. We've got the green R53, the silver F56, and we've also got the Porsche green BRZ that you've seen plenty of videos going up lately. So keep an eye out on the channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. The thread bits, and there's actually little holes on the